Friends, welcome to PySpark video tutorials. In this video, I'm going to give you a few interview questions related to Spark SQL or common data warehousing SQL. If you are attending any interviews on data engineering or data warehousing or any ETL technologies, so primarily we can expect these common interview questions like find the 5th highest salary or 4th highest or 10th highest salary from employee table, or find top 3 paid employees, I can say top 3 highest salaries employees from employee table, or get employee numbers which is under particular manager, reporting manager, which is more than 2 employees. Okay, then find the minimum salary or maximum salary without using aggregations. Without using aggregations means which we should not use a minimum and maximum aggregation functions. So without using, how we will find minimum and maximum salaries, and find the number of rows without using count. Find the maximum rows without using the count, or find even rows or odd rows from a table. So these all are common questions which we can expect in any data warehousing or data engineering or big data, primarily SQL related, you can expect that. So for this, what I'm doing, so I'm using employee table here. So I have a table. So the table is having a few employees records. This is a common employees data where you can expect in most of the examples which we will explain, right? So using this employee table, it's having a 15 records. You can find the minimum salary or maximum salary or top highest salary or maybe manager. So how many people are reporting under one manager? So we need to find the more than one person reporting managers. So like this, we can use this data and we can answer these questions. So when it comes to highest salary, 5th highest salary. So 5th highest salary means if you are using Oracle. So if you are using Oracle, so Oracle is having a row number, but here we don't have a direct row number, we have to use a window functions. So Windows functions, when it comes to Windows functions, so I will use alias name here, employee table alias name, and then e dot star all columns. Then there are ranking functions are available, rank over, and we are looking at highest salary, so or maybe you can say 5th highest salary. So order by salary descending order. So if you use the salary descending order, it will display salary highest to lowest. Then you can say this one, salary DESE, salary descending order. Just I'm creating alias name for this rank. So when you use this, order by is missing, sorry. Yeah. So when you use this, what will happen? Rank will generate a sequence numbers. But if any, like some employees will have the same salary, right? So there you will get an issue. Why? Because whenever you use a row number or rank, if you have the same salary also, it will give the same rank. But when it comes to next one, it is skipping that rank. So you cannot identify exact 5th highest salary if you use rank. Okay, because rank will skip the sequences. So instead of that, what we can do, we can go with dense rank. So if you use dense rank, what will happen, it won't skip the sequences. If you look at this, first highest salary, second highest salary 3000 3000, then third highest salary uses this. Okay, then how we will filter this, how we will filter this, because this is alias name. So alias name, it won't accept in where class. Alias name, it won't accept in where class. See here. So alias name, it is not able to identify as a column. Then we need to go with subquery, from class subquery. So select star from this subquery, which is inner query. So inner query alias name, outer query it will treat as a column name. Outer query it will treat as a column name. Now we can go with the condition saying that the salary, which is of this column rank 5, you can say 5th highest salary. 5th highest salary is this one. So this way, which we can identify 5th highest salary. One is a window function that is called dense rank. Using a dense rank, we can identify fifth highest salary. Then find top three highest salaries from employee table. Top three means which is, so instead of single number, maybe less than equal to 3. So less than equal to 3 means which you can expect top 3. These are not top 3. 4 records are available, but this employee is having the same salary. That's why you can see here. So this is the second question where you can go with finding the same just using a dense rank. We will generate ranks for each employee salary descending order. Then we can fetch that. This is the second question. Get more than 2 employees under one manager. So get more than 2 employees and one manager means we need to take the count at each manager. In the same window function, count is available. Count order by, sorry, not order by, we need to use partition by manager. Okay, so manager, just partition by manager, or you can say manager alias name I'm using. Okay, so this will return count of number of employees under each manager. Count of number of employees at each manager. So this manager, under him there are 2 employees. This manager, under him there are 5 employees. But we need get more than 2 employees under manager. So more than 2 means we need to use again a subquery, select a star from. So more than 2 employees reporting under one manager. So we need to find that number of. So again we can use a where class, this manager greater than 1. So greater than 1 means, so these all are, we can say this. So this, under him there are 3 employees, you can see. Okay, under this manager you can find. So if you're not looking for all columns, just you need only manager, then use that column. So distinct manager. So these are our managers. So if you're looking at count also, then you can see. So under him, this many employees, 2 employees under him, 5 employees under him, 3 employees. So this way we can achieve that same window functions. Then find a minimum or maximum salary without using aggregation functions. This is very important. So we can use aggregation functions, but still someone will ask you how we will achieve this without using aggregation functions. So I want to find the minimum or maximum salary. Normally what we will do, select minimum salary from employee table. This is very simple. But if you want to identify minimum salary from a table or maximum salary from a table without using this aggregation functions. Okay, so for that what we will do, first we need to compare that which one is a minimum record, which one is a maximum record. So row by row scanning should be done. So row by row scanning means which we need to do self join. The same table we will use, employee E and E1. Okay, then where A dot salary less than, or you can say greater than. So greater than, or you can say less than B dot, sorry, E dot salary maybe greater than E1 dot salary. So when you use this, it will verify that each column, then it will give you the total salaries except minimum salary. You can see this, it will give you, but it is like a cross join. So cross join means row by row it will do scanning. So row by row do it will scanning. It is also a costly operation, but still for interview point of view you can do this. Then so what we will do, we will go with again where class subquery. Where class subquery means select star from again same table, where salary not in. So salary not in other than this. Other than this. Okay, it has salary. So other than this means which is minimum salary. You can see this. So using this condition, this subquery which we can achieve minimum salary. Same thing, maximum salary means less than condition. So less than condition means row by row scanning will happen. It will identify, then one row will be missing for which is a maximum, because we are using a less than, then that record you can see this. So this way we can achieve minimum salary or maximum salary from a table. See, so this is maximum salary. If you go to this table, select max salary from a table. So just select it. See here, 5000. So minimum salary 667. So less to greater than 667. Okay. So this is another method. Then next question: find number of rows without using count. So normally, if you want to know a count, we will apply count. Okay. So count star or count one, which will give you total number of rows in this table. So 15 rows are available. But if you want to do without using aggregation function, so which we can achieve using row number. So we can generate a sequence number, then we can achieve that. So sequence number, which is a row number, we can use, and we can generate a row number on entire data set. Entire data set means if it is a table which is having a huge number of data also, we can apply. So just I'm applying order by employee number, it will generate a sequence number, any sequence number from just alias name is row ID from employee table. So it will give you a row number 1 to 15. It will give you a row number 1 to 15. Okay. So here you can see the number of rows. So number of rows, here you can see total 15 rows are available. But without using a count. So without using a count means here the maximum value is 15. So you can apply select maximum of this row ID. So these are just understanding your third process. So okay, any other than this, any approach is available or not. So count is the best approach. Still, do you have any other approaches which we can implement? So that's why, so most of the people will ask you this type of questions. See here. So that is called total number of rows are available, 15 rows. So this is another method where you can achieve that. Then the last question is find even or odd numbers in a table. So even row or odd row, how we will identify? So I have a 1 million records. I want only total rows, only even rows. The same subquery concept, again aggregation. So again subquery and aggregation, which we can achieve that. So what we will do, we will generate row number for all columns, I can say for all the data, just alias name. Okay, so this is your row number and this is your data. If you are looking for even rows or odd rows, so again we will apply subquery select star from. So in where class, so what we will do, we will use this row number divided by 2. If remainder is 0, if remainder is 0, which you can, those all are, you can say even rows. These are all, you can see 2, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. If remainder is 1, those all are odd rows. So this is the approach where we can achieve finding even row or odd row. So just generating a sequence ID using a row number, we are generating sequence ID, we can achieve that. So these all are common questions which you can expect in SQL related. Just to understand, do you have a other process or having a knowledge or experience on window functions primarily? So primarily window functions. Using window functions, how we will achieve our requirement. So thank you for watching my videos. Please subscribe my channel if you're not subscribed. Thank you very much.